This afternoon, the federal government has opened criminal and civil investigations into the Deepwater Horizon explosion and oil spill. WDSU News reporter Gina Swanson joins us now live in the news center. And Gina, I understand the U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder made the announcement today right here in New Orleans. What did he say?
Absolutely, Scott. First, we want to be very clear that he made the announcement today that these criminal and civil probes are open, but he says that they have been open for several weeks now. He actually reiterated the president's comments that he made on Friday while visiting. He says that every person responsible will be held accountable, and this time he will use every law available to him at his disposal to enforce just these violations, Scott.
What's the scope of this investigation?
The scope of it is actually huge. Now, Eric Holder today called this whole situation heartbreaking. He said it was absolutely a tragedy, but he says that there are laws involved from those that could protect birds to those all the way that could involve negligence when it comes to the 11 lives lost when the rig exploded. He says there are things like the Clean Water Act, the Oil Pollution Act from 1990 that went into effect after Exxon Valdez. So definitely a whole battery of laws that they are considering. They are not leaving any stone unturned. That's certainly the case.
So is that just about everybody that's involved in this, or does it go further than that?
It actually encompasses several federal agencies. He says, you know, he has the FBI looking into it. He has the U.S. attorneys in all the Gulf states looking into it. He actually met with the attorneys general from all the Gulf states as well. So this is not only a federal probe. The companies could be facing state charges as well. The thing that he stopped short of saying was just what is the target of the investigation. We know there are some major companies involved, BP, Halliburton, and Transocean, but he didn't want to say specifically who they were looking at. But he did say that this encompasses, as we mentioned, everything, including whether or not people even made false statements while testifying before Congress. So they're certainly have launched an extensive investigation.